Etymologists of Reddit. What is the coolest origin of the word? Entomologist of Reddit. What's your best bug fact? Etymology. Dashboard. The dashboard is a board on the front of a horse carriage meant to keep mud from kicking up on the passengers when the horse dashes. And over time it came to mean the front part of anything. Even a computer interface is sometimes called a dashboard. Ampersand. And, used to be a letter in the English alphabet. It came after Z in the An alphabet. In the alphabet song, after you finished with Z, kids would sing and percent, which is where the name ampersand comes from. And percent basically means also and as itself. When I was little we had a blackboard that had the alphabet listed across the top, followed by an ampersand. So when we sang the alphabet song we ended with Z and ampersand. This would have been in the very late 50s. The word barbarian comes from an ancient Greek word referring to all non-Greek speakers, including Egyptians, Phoenicians, etc. This was because to the Greeks, all other languages sounded like people saying bar bar bar. This became the root for the word barbarous, barbarous, which roughly means babble or gibberish. It was later adopted by the Romans to refer to any culture that did not practice Greek or Roman traditions, even though Latin speakers were technically classified as barbarians because they didn't speak Greek. Due to good old xenophobia, it eventually came to mean uncivilized, and from there it made its way through the centuries into Middle English. Barbarians are also responsible for one of the best Roman laws, the No Pants Edict, in which Emperor Honorius banned pants in Rome. Entomologist here. Some walking sticks copulate for over 70 days. I needed a second to realize you didn't mean little walking sticks. The word bear in many languages in Europe including English just means brown thing. There used to be a proper name for bear, but it was taboo because saying it was believed to summon a bear, who would then kill everyone. It was so taboo it was eventually forgotten and the euphemism, brown thing, became the name. Ancient people were scared pissless by bears. In Eastern Slavic languages they were so scared that even the brown thing became taboo. The word is still used as a part of bear's lair name, but the animal itself is named as the one who knows where is honey. Roger is just the modern English equivalent of the Old English and Old Norse name Hrothgar. Hrothgar that. Etymology. Melon not particularly interesting in itself. It came from ancient Greek, through Latin, to Old French, before finding its way to English. All along the way it referred to various goods, however, and this is the interesting bit, melons was slang for boobs in Greek, and it retained this slang definition as well as its real definition all the way to English. Usually in etymology you keep one definition or the other, and never both, which makes it really interesting. Also boobies. Entomology. The Japanese red bug, in addition to having the most creative bug name ever, is one of the few known non-eusocial, eusocial, colony bugs like ants, bees, termites, insect to take care of its young after they hatch. The word quintessential has one of my favorite etymologies. You can break it down into quint and essential. Quint as in five, essential as in essence, or element. To be quintessential is to be the fifth element of something, to be the thing's spirit. So the fifth element is a quintessential movie no matter what anybody says. The etymology of tawdry is a real ride. There was a 7th century Anglo-Saxon son named Athelthryth. Now, nobody, not even 7th century Anglo-Saxons, wants to go around trying to pronounce that dense forest of s, so she was commonly known as Saint Etheldreda, and later, linguistically lazier people called her Saint Audrey. Saint Audrey was the patron son of a town called Ely, and the folks of Ely held a fair every year in her name. One of the primary products on offer at these fairs was lace. Saint Audrey's lace was said a few too many times, and got slurred down to tawdry lace. Over time, the lace fell out of favor. It was mainly made by peasant women, and thus viewed as cheap, and the Puritans looked down on lace garments of any kind as ostentatious. Tawdry then began to be used to describe other things that were cheap and ostentatious, and the modern definition of the word was born. My name is Audrey. I went through a cringy phase where I used Athelthryth when asked my name and even set it as my FB name. Etymology. Nightmare. The mare part of the word nightmare comes from Germanic folklore, in which a mare is an evil female spirit or goblin that sits upon a sleeper's chest, suffocating them and or giving them bad dreams. So basically the word comes from a description of sleep paralysis. Entomology. Honeybees have to make about 10 million trips to collect enough nectar for production of 1 pound of honey. In German, Albtraum reflects this folklore as well. ALB being an older word for elf, so elf dream. The elf in this case being more like the goblin that sits on your chest rather than what we think of today as elves. The word apron was originally napron, but when people said an apron it got gradually transformed into an apron. I have no bug facts. Napkin and napron have similar etymologies. Etymology. Nimrod was originally a compliment referring to one's hunting skills, Nimrod being a biblical figure known for his ability to hunt. But the definition changed because people didn't understand Bugs Bunny was calling Elmer Fudd a Nimrod sarcastically. Entomology. Earwigs have wings and can fly. Etymology. Calcium, calculator, calculate, calculus, abacus all share an origin in the word calx, Latin for stone. Renal calculus equals kidney stone. Malaria. Malaria is an infectious disease characterized by chills and fever and caused by the bite of an infected Anopheles mosquito. This word comes from the medieval Italian mal, bad, and aria, air, describing the miasma from the swamps around Rome. This bad air was believed to be the cause of the fever that often developed in those who spent time around the swamps. In fact, the illness, now known as malaria, was due to certain protozoans present in the mosquitoes that bred around these swamps, and which caused recurring feverish symptoms in those they bit. 2-in-1. Very nice. Etymology. Shibboleth was a Hebrew word for a part of a plant, but at one point it was used to determine whether someone belonged to one cultural group or another because the groups pronounced the word differently. But now, it refers to words and phrases like those that out someone as part of a particular group, whether it's by pronunciation or understanding. For example, get a native German speaker to say squirrel and they almost definitely won't be able to. Entomology. Some wasps inject their eggs into a host and the host gets mind controlled to protect the developing babies. The interesting thing is that it's not the eggs that control the host but a virus that the wasp injects along with the eggs. Orange. The word for the fruit came long before the word for the color. We just called things which were the color orange, yellow, red. Additionally, William of Orange, William II of England has nothing to do with either the color or the fruit. The word oxymoron. The word oxymoron itself, appropriately enough, is an oxymoron. The oxy part, the same as in words like oxygen, paroxysm and peroxide, comes from the Greek word for sharp or acrid, oxys. The moron part, the same as in, well, moron, comes from the Greek word for dull, moros. So an oxymoron is literally a sharp dull turn of phrase. Portmanteau is a portmanteau, portage and manteau. I love the origin of berserk. It comes from Old Norse for bear shirt, where Vikings would put on shirts made of the hide of skinned bears and I guess get possessed by the spirit of the bear and just go absolutely up a shit on whatever. The word queue, meaning a long stick used in billiards, comes from the French word queue, meaning tail. The English word queue also comes from the French word, the Latin word corda, from which queue ultimately derives, also brought us English coda, but that comes via Italian instead of French. The word queue, meaning an indication that it's time for something to happen, or as a verb, to give such an indication, comes from the letter Q. It was written as an abbreviation for quando, Latin, when, on actors' partial copies of play scripts. To save on paper, your copy of the script wouldn't include every line, just the ones right before your lines, marked with Q. So you'd have to learn your cues to know when your line was coming. A little late to this thread, but my favorite one isn't on here yet. Mortgage. Mort. Death. Gage. Pledge. Death pledge. Very fitting for a 30-year loan. Etymology. The word avocado comes from the Aztec word for testicle. That's literally the only one I can think of right now. Entomology. The largest insect on earth, the wheater, has a unique survival mechanism. When winter rolls around, they die. They physically die. There is no heartbeat or brain activity, and their brains rot. Nobody knows how they do it, but the moment the weather warms up and the frozen wheater thaw, even without their brains, their hearts restart, and they go on to breed before dying for real. Also, they hiss. Good luck with that. Dang millennials with their testicles on toast. Entomology. You can kill cockroaches with plain isopropyl alcohol in a spray bottle. You don't need to buy those special bug sprays if you only need to kill them on the spot. Spray them, and don't stop, because they will try to run away, but they'll die after a couple minutes. Try to catch them in a can, spray the crap out of them with alcohol and they'll die. Works because they dry out and die. Never had to resort to a broom. Also, more environmentally safe and won't hurt your pets. Unless your pets get all dried out. 3 yards year entomology undergrad here. There are actually plenty of interesting bug facts. My favorite are parasitoid wasps and mind control. Some parasitoid wasps can actually inject a toxin into a caterpillar to get it to defend its eggs from aphids, the wasp's predator. The caterpillar previously wouldn't care if an aphid crawled on it, and now will flick them off. Another interesting parasitoid wasps fact is that some of their mycnemonids especially have such sensitive sensory structures on their feet, tarsus, that can detect a moving grub within a tree, and doctors are actually trying to figure out how to detect something so sensitive to apply it to internal human issues. Here is another interesting fact about flies. Most insects have 4 wings, and in Diptera, flies, they have 2 reduced wings called halters instead of hind wings that help immensely with flight balance orientation. That's why flies are so hard to hit. Their halteres can detect the air movement and adjust to it quicker than you can hit it. What is really interesting is that not much about insects is known. They are such a prevalent species. Even the most important evolutionary process in insects, flight, is not fully studied. There are 2 prominent theories about how insect wings developed. I can go on all day. Bad in English apparently comes from an old word for hermaphrodite. But what is also interesting is that Persian has the word bad, which means the exact same thing but developed independently, despite the fact that the languages are related. And funnily enough, better looks a lot like better, and it means better too. Newborn honeybees don't have hardened stingers because they haven't dried out enough. Also, their wings are still drying so they can't fly. This leads to a lot of fun in the lab because they can be pet and held. Luciferase, the enzyme responsible for fireflies glowing, comes from the name Lucifer, which means light bearer. In Greek mythology, Hades had a giant 3-headed dog named Cerberus that guarded the entrance to the land of the dead. Cerberus comes from an older Sanskrit word, Cerberus, meaning spotted. So Hades, a literal Greek god, has a hellhound named Spot. Disclaimer, I am not an etymologist, and this is disputed. I still like it. Whoa, good timing. I just learned this one today. Etymology of the word clue. The word clue originates with the myth of Theseus, who used a ball of yarn to find his way back out of the Minotaur's labyrinth. The Middle English word for a ball of yarn was clue, or clew. When the myth was popularized in England by Chaucer, people started using the word clue figuratively to mean a hint or guide to solving a problem. Edit, holy forking shirt balls. This blew up. I have so many internet points now. Obligatory thanks for the gold, kind stranger. Interesting. The word for clue in Swedish is ledtråd, which is translated to lead thread or path thread, so it's probably related to the same myth. I don't know much etymology, but I have some basic entomology. Even though most people think termites are close to ants because of their appearance and social habits, they are actually way closer to cockroaches and have been considered part of the same order for a while now. The Indian Marathi word and the American Native Cherokee word for squirrel, celery, are by pure coincidence the same. NSW-ish entomology fact, ever heard of Spanish fly? Well, it's actually a beetle, specifically one belonging to a group known commonly as blister beetles. They secrete a substance known as cantharidin that does exactly what you think it does. This substance has also been used as an aphrodisiac. When consumed, it reacts the same way it would if you got some on your skin. Starting with the softest tissues, you end up with an itch that you can't scratch in your most delicate areas. It's also super easy to overdose on, leading to a rather unpleasant end. Sometimes horses will die as a result of blister beetles getting into their feed. There was an episode of Jeopardy recently where the final Jeopardy's subject was surnames. It had to do with a common Italian last name that is associated with speed and style. and it derives from the Latin word for iron. The answer was Ferrari. I thought that was kind of neat. English used to have a letter called thorn, which kind of looked like the letter Y. It made a buzzing th sound like in the. It's why you see signs like ye olde shop. It's pronounced the old shop, not ye old shop. Assassin. N. 1530s. In Anglo-Latin from mid-13C, via French and Italian, from Arabic hashishii and hashish users, plural of hashishii, from the source of hashish, QV, a fanatical Ismaili Muslim sect of the mountains of Lebanon in the time of the Crusades, under leadership of the Old Man of the Mountains, translates Arabic Sheikh al-Jaibal, name applied to Hassan ibn al-Sabah. They had a reputation for murdering opposing leaders after intoxicating themselves by eating hashish. The plural suffix in was mistaken in Europe for part of the word. Compare Bedouin. Middle English had the word as assace. Mid-14C, from Old French hassasis, assasis, which is from the Arabic word. Sophomore. It means wise fool in ancient Greek. I also like, comma hazard, which meant the die in Arabic. Because gambling was considered risky, comma trivia, which meant three roads in Latin, because patricians looked down upon such intersections with disdain, as being insignificant and full of commoners, comma candidate, which means white-robed, comma avocado, which in Nahuatl shared a definition with testicle, comma orchid, which in Greek meant testicle, comma testify, which is a cognate of testicle, comma porcelain, which means pig's vagina, comma vanilla, which means vagina, comma girl, which could once refer to either gender, comma toilet, which used to mean closet in French, and many, many more. While making stone sculptures, it was highly likely that the carver will make a mistake which cannot be undone, especially if he was not very skilled. To hide their mistakes, they used to apply wax and shape it accordingly. The sculpture with wax was seen as impure and with flaws representing dishonesty of the carver. The Spanish for wax is cera. Hence the sculptures without wax were called sincera in Spanish. From there came the word sincere, that is, without any flaw or pure is archaic meaning and now meaning honest. The word vaccine comes from the Latin word vaccinus, which means of the cow. This is because the guy that first popularized the treatment and term prevented smallpox in children by exposing them to material from a cowpox blister, a milder form of smallpox. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.